We got a message on Facebook from Stephanie, and she sent us a clip from a Dallas news station down in Texas, WFAA. I'm thinking like, okay, well, we're not going to play this on the show. It's Dallas, Texas. This better be funny.
Right.
Oh, it is. It's not funny, the material, though. Apparently, they're having some real issues with staffing and understaffing and at this hospital in Dallas. You know, a common occurrence with healthcare in our country. Nurses, doctors, staff being overworked, understaffed,
sure, yeah,
in charge of too many patients, mm-hmm, can't give patients the care that they need. So let's hear what happened as some employees are talking out about their struggles at a hospital in Dallas, Texas. Just wait for the end.
To your staff.
After a career monitoring patients' hearts, Nichelle Reynolds' own is hurting.
How can you do that to your staff?
Yeah.
I think that that's okay.
She is one of nearly 160 people White Rock Medical Center laid off last week.
It's just awful, right? 160 people get laid off. Yeah, they're already understaffed. We're talking about a hospital down in Dallas. You hear from Michelle there. She's obviously, you know, torn up about it and everything.
The facility, formerly known as Doctors Hospital, says it had to stop taking ambulances for nearly a week.
That's insane to even think about. A hospital in Dallas, like one of the most big major cities in the country, had to stop taking ambulances because they were understaffed for a week. Just seems completely insane, like, that this happens in the United States of America. But just wait for Michelle to come back here
because of it.
I don't feel bad about saying it. I would not be a patient at that hospital at all.
All right, so she wouldn't even be a patient in the hospital herself.
Right.
It's run so bad.
Yeah.
But hold on.
She would not go back for medical care nor a job.
I crap in my hands and clap before I went back up there.
I've never heard that phrase in my life, and I feel like I'm going to use it daily from here on out.
I would crap in
Michelle.
My hands and clap before I went back up there.
So she said, you got two options. You can go back to work at the hospital, or you can defecate in your hand and clap.
It is such a completely, like, serious news story up until that moment.
It is. It's understaffed hospitals. It's bad. And I know
she's
people
emotional.
In this area and, and healthcare, you feel this struggle. You feel this pain. We need help. We need help.
I'd crap in my hands and clap before I went back up there.
I'd crap in my hands and clap before I went
what
back up there to that hospital, Michelle.
I'd crap in my hands and clap before I went back up there.
I want to see this lady on the Today Show, Good Morning America. She should be interviewed by every major news outlet about the issues happening at the hospital down in Dallas, and really just for her quote.
I'd crap in my hands and clap before I went back up there.
I'd crap in my hands and clap. All the best to you, Michelle. Hopefully you find some new employment that really, really, you know, respects the person and the worker and employee that you are.